This video tutorial I will explain how to trace microservice logs. Here you can see Spring Boot demo, and it is a microservice and it exposes one REST endpoint to get the employee details. And here you can see Spring Boot REST template demo, and it is another microservice, and from this microservice using REST template we will call Spring Boot demo microservice to get the employee details. And here you can see Postman client. Using Postman client, we will send request to this microservice, and from this microservice we will send request to this microservice, and we will see how to trace the logs. Suppose we are working on multiple microservice, and in one of the microservice if any issue occurred, then tracing the log is very difficult. To resolve this issue, we have to use Spring Cloud Sleuth and Sipkin server for Spring Boot application. In pom.xml, we have to include the dependency of Spring Cloud Starter Sleuth, and we have to include dependency like this. Here you can see the sample log of Spring Boot REST template demo microservice. Here you can see the sample log of Spring Boot demo microservice. Spring Cloud Sleuth logs are printed in this format. The first one is application name. The second one is trace ID. And the third one is span ID. And the fourth one is Sipkin export. Application name is the name of the application. In this case, name of the application is Spring Boot REST template demo. In this case, name of the application is Spring Boot demo. And trace ID between one microservice to another microservice will be same. Using trace ID, we can track the logs. And the third one is span ID, which will be different for each request and response. And one microservice to another microservice, the span ID will be different. And fourth one is Sipkin export. By default, it will be false. And if it is true, then logs will be exported to Sipkin server. Here you can see Spring Boot demo application with folder structure. Here you can see the pom.xml. Here you can see application.properties file, and name of the application is Spring Boot demo. Here I have defined a class employee service controller, which is REST controller, and it has a get employees method. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is get. This method returns a list of employees to the caller. And here I have defined the logger, and when this method is called, I am printing this log. Here I have defined the class application, which is Spring Boot application. I am starting this Spring Boot application. The Spring Boot application is started in 8080 port. Here you can see Spring Boot REST template demo application with folder structure. And here you can see the pom.xml. Here you can see application.properties file, and here I have defined server port as 9090 and application name as Spring Boot REST template demo. Here I have defined a class employee service controller, which is REST controller, and it has a get employees method. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is get. From this method, we are making a call to Spring Boot demo microservice REST endpoint to get the list of employees. And here I have defined the logger, and once this method is called, I am printing this log. Here I have defined a class REST template application, which is a Spring Boot application. I am starting this Spring Boot application. The Spring Boot application is started in 9090 port. Using Postman client, I am sending request to Spring Boot REST template demo application. The request reaches to Spring Boot REST template demo application. Here you can see the log has been printed. This is the application name. This is the trace ID. This is the span ID. And this one is Sipkin export. From here, using REST template, we are making call to Spring Boot demo microservice REST endpoint. I am copying this trace ID. The request reached to Spring Boot demo microservice. And here it is printing the log. Application name, trace ID, span ID, Sipkin export. Control F. This trace ID I have copied from the Spring Boot REST template demo application. Searching here, and here you can see the same trace ID is printing in Spring Boot demo microservice. So trace ID between one microservice to another microservice is same. Using the trace ID, we can track the logs. Here we got the output. I am sending one more request. Copy this trace ID from Spring Boot REST template demo application. And to find the corresponding log in Spring Boot demo application, search here. Copy the trace ID, click on find, and here you can see the corresponding log is this one. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.